Nice to see you here. Ich mach die gemacht, I think. Roger, it's your first solo track.
Yes, the first solo album from anyone in Queen. About 2 years ago, I started, and then I started to record. The ideas were 2 years ago, and then I recorded about 1 year ago. Mm-hmm. And it took about 6 weeks in between.
Okay. Fiction conception on the album.
Yes, it's a sort of science fiction thing. It's got big graphic horizons.
Yeah. T-shirt sehe ich, Flash Gordon. Es war ein sehr erfolgreicher Film, auch bei uns. Ornella Muti bekam den Bambi dafür vor einiger Zeit. Und die er mag sie sehr, die Ornella, hat er mir viel schon erzählt. Und der Soundtrack wurde von Queen geschrieben. Die Single war Nummer 2 in Deutschland, die LP Nummer 3. And is it possible that Queen will make other soundtracks for other films in the future?
No, not until Stanley Kubrick comes along and makes us an offer we can't possibly refuse.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Okay. Also Queen hat den Soundtrack gemacht, aber do you want to play the songs on your album now? Perhaps live with other musicians?
Yeah, it would be very nice, but it's impossible because I'd have to do it 100%. So I'm very happy with Queen.
And okay.
On the table and kick it.
I know what I can try.
On the table and kick it.
What? Oh, fuck. The Midwest could get on your nerves because of the sheer repetition of it, and every town looks so much like the other. And you did feel like you were in a culture vacuum sometimes.
Sorry.
All we have is bad televisions, vibrating beds, even worse, and bad food. But it was still a lot of fun. There was loads of sex and drugs. And, no, there really wasn't much sex and, well, there wasn't much drugs.
They give me these horrible things with about 2p's and...
Oh, hey!
We did stay pretty connected. Generally, we sort of found a big place where we'd all get ready together and we would kind of joke around and talk about stuff. So we had a good kind of camaraderie, which kept us alive.
Arnold!
Ah.
together until there's no longer any point in it sticking together, see what I mean? But mind you, when it is all over and there's not really much coming out of it anymore, you've got to quit then, I think. I'm sure we will when that happens.
Find if you're successful to any degree, because there's a million sharks out there.
That you couldn't even leave your hotels, that's the
It was very
popularity.
Difficult. Yeah, very difficult.
Well, this time around, it was... We had bodyguards all around.
The kitchens, though.
In fact, yes, and we were sort of reduced to travelling in laundry lifts and things like that. But the price of fame, they tell me.
Bringing ballet to the masses, then, Fred.
Freddie was always so keen, and he literally sort of taught himself to play, to understand chords on a guitar, etc., etc.
Had Freddie had any experience at all?
None at all before Smile was formed. Absolutely none, apart from Cliff Richard impersonations in front of his mirror. And I suddenly realised that I couldn't stand not being in a group. Mm. So that's when I met Brian. I met him through my flatmate at Imperial College, which is a different college to mine. I met him in the bar one night because he wrote me a letter after I replied, "Add, we need Ginger Baker, Mitch Mitchell-type drummer." And Brian wrote me this long, involved letter, and he sounded quite intelligent, you know, because he liked Jeff Beck and Jimi Hendrix. So I met him, and we got on very well. And that was a sort of bit... And Freddie sort of got us. He said, "Come on, you can't give up. I want to sing for you." And nobody really took him that seriously, but he really sort of fused it together. And then which made a core of about... There was one particular gig at Imperial College, and we were just building up a little bit of buzz because some of the gigs had been getting good. And this gig really went well. That was a very good turning point.
What do you think for sounds? I mean, I think we should just...
Yeah, it sounds all right to me.
Yes, he's only done drum sounds at the moment.
It sounds right, doesn't it? Oh, well, that's right. It sounds all right to me, doesn't it?
Especially a group in our stage of career can fall into the trap where we can have as much time as we want in the studio. And you can just
open a bottle of wine.
Yes, well, where is the screwdriver?
Congratulations, you're number one on the hit line at the moment. How's that for loyalty?
I think it's great. I quite enjoy all this battle, you know, between ABBA and whoever, you know, X, no, whatever, you know. It's very enjoyable, you know. It's always when I sort of... I must admit, I did quite often tune in, and it's nice to hear if it's not wrong. It's a very good instant reaction to what you've sort of put out.
And only Queen could come up with the title We Are the Champions. I mean, where's the modesty gone?
Well, there isn't any. There's no modesty whatsoever. After the slaggings off what we get from the English music press, I mean, who cares? I mean, we've got nothing to lose now.
I think Queen fans will be surprised because it's far more kind of raw than any other album and also shorter tracks.
I'm glad you said raw because that was exactly really what we wanted.
I'd like to make it naked and raw.
What we wanted.
Okay, you're ready to rock and roll!
Changed all my own words.
Who did?
That rotter Freddie.